What's up, Kansas City? My name is Tennille Benton, and we're here with Cascade Media Group for The Real with Tennille Show. I am here with acclaimed ringmaster Andre McClain from the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what it takes to be a ringmaster. Mr. McClain, tell us a little bit about what you do and how you got into it.
Well, I am the ringmaster of Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus. Ringling's been around for 143 years. Now, that's older than baseball. That's older than Coca-Cola. That's even older than the state of Arizona. Before joining Ringling, I watched a guy here in Kansas City named Rex Purifoy, which I am from Kansas City. I watched Rex growing up as a kid doing trick roping, training trick horses, performing in the middle of these rodeo arenas. So I had never seen a circus as a child. So I said, you know what? I want to be that guy. I want to be just like him. And so what I did was I got ropes and I got horses and I started training trick horses and taught myself how to trick and fancy rope just like him. And I moved to Denver and I decided I wanted to add more to my repertoire. I had this one-man cowboy show and I wanted to add more to it. So I went to the circus to learn how to still walk. And I went to Ringling for the first time 13 years ago and met a talent scout there. And he came out, he met me, he said, the owners, the producers at the time, Kenneth Fell, wanted to see what I did. And so they paid for everything for me to go to Texas to show my out what I did in rodeos. And so that's what I did, and I've been there ever since. I started off as the all-access pre-show host, which is a part of the show that starts 1 hour before showtime, is where you can try on costumes, come down the arena floor, meet all the performers, get autographs, and just have a great time. And so I did that for 10 years. And it's so funny because my second year with Ringling, I said, you know what? Now I want to be the ringmaster. I want to be that guy. So I went to Nicole and Alana Feld, who were the producers at the time. I told Nicole Feld, I said, I want to be that guy. She says, Andre, you're not ready for that yet. And so I said, okay. So I didn't care about that anymore. I didn't care about being the ringmaster. Until a couple of years ago, I was the pre-show host and animal trainer with Ringling. And so a couple of years ago, the talent scout came back up to me. He said, the Felds want you to be their next ringmaster of the 143rd edition of Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus, and that's what I became.
Excellent, excellent. So what life experiences prepared you to bring the to be the ringmaster of Ringling Brothers? Because my whole life, I'm 38, and my whole life, 38 years, we've always, every year, my parents have taken us to the circus to see Ringling Brothers. So what, I feel like you're an icon. Ringling Brothers is iconic.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. You know, it's still, till today, it's an honor and a privilege to be a ringmaster of the greatest show on earth. There's been more presidents of the United States of America than ringmasters of the greatest show on earth. So it's an honor, it's a privilege. And, you know, I'm like the biggest fan of the circus. That's what I am as a ringmaster. I'm like a fan of all these artists. I mean, these guys risk their lives each and every day. I mean, imagine being 35 feet in the air, walking a wire only as wide as your thumb. Imagine flying across an arena floor,
right, with 65 miles, net.
Absolutely, 65 miles an hour out of a cannon, 65 miles an hour, 40 feet in the air, out of this big, huge cannon. You know, so I'm a fan. You know, I'm an over-glorified fan, that is. But I'm also commanding, so I'm also somebody that all the performers and the crew and the staff can look up to.
Excellent, excellent. So what would you tell other young up-and-coming artists or people that are thinking about being a ringmaster or joining the circus in any type of capacity? What do they need to do? Is there a training or is it just a gift? It's just naturally in you?
You know what? I say this. I say no matter what you want to do in life, whether it's a ringmaster, whether it's be president, no matter what it is in life, you know, stay focused, get your education, and do it. Because believe one thing, you too can make your dreams come true.
Excellent. Now, there are other circuses out there, but I truly believe that Ringling Brothers has paved the way.
Oh, yes.
This is like, it's like phenomenal. How is it, how do they get everybody together?
Well, we have a talent scout that does nothing but goes all over the world searching for talent. And when we put a new show together, we have a creative team. So we have a writer, we have a director, we have a choreographer. And we hire the best of the best to come together to build new shows every year. That way you see a new show every year, and we keep it contemporary with the day and time, but also keep it traditional like everyone else likes.
Now, how difficult is it to narrow down when you have all of these countries and all these states who have people that think they're great, and they can be a ringmaster, or they can fly out of a cannon? Is it really stiff competition to be in the circus?
No, not at all. I mean, it's like before, you know, you just keep focused and keep on driving. There's room for everybody.
Excellent, excellent. How long were you preparing before you actually got to be the ringmaster?
You know, I was never preparing because I never thought that I was going to be. I never imagined I was going to be. So it was just, I was just living my dream as it came.
Okay. So can I ask you, does it pay well to be a ringmaster?
Well, you know, I can't tell you all that.
Oh, you can't?
I do live wonderful. They do take great care of me.
Okay. So can I quit my job and be your personal assistant? Would you take great care of me too?
Absolutely.
I'm serious. I'm going to quit tomorrow if you're sincere.
Okay, don't quit tomorrow.
Okay, I'm going to leave about 2 weeks. Excellent, excellent. Okay, I'm here with Andre McClain, ringmaster for Ringling Brothers. Is there anything that you would tell any young upcoming artists, whether they want to go into the circus or not, of what they should do to be successful?
You know, just stay focused. You know, stay focused. I'm the first equestrian singing ringmaster in over 100 years of Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey. But I encourage everyone to, you know, stay focused, keep going forward. And like I said, you too can make your dreams come true no matter what you want to be, no matter what you want to do. Just keep on moving forward.
Now, you're an equestrian and you sing. Now, I know what an equestrian is, but can you tell that to our viewing audience?
You know, I train horses. I ride horses. I've trained camels. I've trained zebras, all types of exotic animals, goats.
Now, do you own any exotic animals yourself?
I have horses.
Excellent. And where do you live? Where do you reside currently?
Right now, I'm headed to Tampa, and I'll live there for a month. But no, okay. I live in Kansas City. I'm originally from here. Okay. But I'm on tour year-round.
Okay, when you say you're on tour year-round, does that mean you're on tour like 40 weeks out of 52, or how?
45 weeks out of the year.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
And are you married? Do you have children?
Married. My wife travels with me. She's one of the dancers in the show.
Oh, my gosh.
And she's from Brazil, and I have two kids. And my daughter travels with me, goes to school on the show, so... It's great.
No, I think that is amazing. How awesome is it to basically have a family business where your family can go with you and travel and participate in all of your activities?
Oh, it's awesome. It's awesome. I get to look at my wife dance every single day. You know, she dances right next to me. She's like my backup singer and dancer throughout the show.
Excellent, excellent. And how old are your children?
14 and 15.
Excellent. Now, 14 and 15 is a rocky age. Have they ever expressed any, I don't want to go on the road with you?
Oh,
or
no. No.
So they're very excited.
Oh, yes. They've been traveling with me for over 13 years now.
Exactly. So what do they do? Are they participating in the show as well?
No. Education.
Education?
Education.
Okay. Since we're talking about education, tell me why education is key.
Ooh, you got to have an education to do anything in life. You know, education is first. You know, I believe in reading. You know, reading is it develops the mind, you know. A lot of us don't do it no more because we, you know,
my goal
because of the internet nowadays.
I read at least 50 books a year. I really,
nice.
I am an avid reader, and I believe that you can change the world one person at a time, starting with yourself, but that you have to be educated, and education comes in all forms.
Mm-hmm.
But reading is definitely fundamental.
Right.
Okay, I have a question, because when I was coming up, the ringmaster of Ringling Brothers was white.
Mm-hmm.
So how hard was it for you to be an African-American or a black man to be a ringmaster? Was it just destined to happen? Or
no, it's like anything. You know, it's the day and time have changed, you know, from the way things were before. And so it's normal now.
Do you mind if I ask your age? Because you look so young. Now, I know you can't ask a woman her age. She doesn't have to divulge. But would you care to share with our audience how old you are?
37.
Oh, my God. So can I say good black doesn't crack and not have anybody beat me up? Okay, great, great. Now, I understand that there is a little bit more involved to what you do with the ringmasters and the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey. Can you tell us a little bit about your brother and his country western music? And do you incorporate that anyway into your performance?
Well, you know, I come home every... twice a year,
okay.
if that. Yeah, my brother sings country western. He plays guitar, he plays drums, and so it's nice to come back and have a jam session every once in a while and just hang out and spend time together.
And tell us your brother's name and where we can find him at.
Brother Al, right here in Kansas City,
and
Missouri.
Brother Al, right here in Kansas City, Missouri. Now, was he instrumental in you becoming a ringmaster? Did he encourage you to pursue your passions and your dreams?
Absolutely. And you know, we're cowboys. You know, we're cowboys first, you know, before circus even came about.
Okay.
So yeah, for sure.
Now, have you performed in any other rodeos or circuses before the Ringling Brothers?
Yeah, I performed around with the Bill Pickett Invitational Rodeo. I performed down at the American Royal. I started singing and my roping down at the American Royal. So, yeah.
Excellent. I want you to tell our viewers before we wrap up one thing that they may not know about you or what it takes to be a ringmaster.
I love barbecue.
Okay, can you tell us your favorite barbecue spots?
I must say Gates Barbecue on 12th Street.
Gates Barbecue on 12th Street. I love Gates Barbecue on 12th Street. Mr. Gates and Kiva, we love you very, very much. Hopefully we can come down and get a free party tray. Woo, woo. No, I'm just teasing. Excellent, excellent. One more thing, even for our viewers who may be thinking about getting into the rodeo or being a ringmaster, what can you tell young up-and-coming equestrians or singers who are thinking about getting into the circus?